Welcome everybody. We are going to try our hand at No Man's Sky.
Commencing add assistance suit initialization. Life support systems activated. Shield kinetic system online. Scanner damaged. Repair required. Aerial propulsion jetpack online. Multi-tool and mining laser attachment operational. User initialization sequence complete.
Welcome to Dresdell. We are crash landed on some planets.
Radiation protection falling.
And it happens to be a radioactive planet. Scanner is damaged. I need to harvest some ferrite dust to fix it. We have some animal life here, which fortunately for us at this moment is not currently attacking us. Let us fix our scanner.
Component repaired. Technology repaired.
Scan for some sodium. Sodium found.
Radiation damage detected.
Sodium to our suit.
Technology recharge.
Okay, we're not 100% on our radiation.
Radiation protection falling.
Let's move all the tech stuff to the tech screen. Find some more.
Starship signal detected.
Okay, I'm here and my ship is all the way there. How did I get there? Or get here? Oh, okay. What am I carrying in my hand? Just want to pick up a bit more sodium. My shield is very low. Maybe I should go a bit faster.
Radiation protection falling.
46%. Let's head towards our ship. Okay. crab-looking creatures. Limit power to our jetpack. Too much damage, just run a little bit. Ooh, okay, we've come across some abandoned resources.
Radiation protection falling.
What kind of plant is this? Nope. It's not giving me any indication. Finally, we have
radiation protection falling.
Found our crashed ship. Let's read our distress beacon. Boundary separation failure likely. Vessel 16 emptied. Cause centennial intervention. Deliberate transfer. Analysis fresh, interaction generated, anomaly containment prepared, broadcast. Broadcast received, traveler anomaly detected. Anomaly is compliant, position logged, system integrity scan initialized. Find myself alone on a strange world, unequipped and in danger. I have no memory of how I got here, no sense of a before. But this ship at least seems to recognize me. The controls react to my touch, or at least to that of my exosuit. I am not dead yet, and the ship is a lifeline out to the stars. Read the log. Log 4925A unavailable. Substituting data. Exosuit connected. Suggestion: pilot should perform maintenance. Select desired repair path. Repair ship systems. Self-guided repair protocols initiated. must require a hermetic seal and metal plating to fix my pulse engine. If I need to make a metal plating, so let us find some ferrite dust. Seeing those funny little
radiation protection falling.
Move. It's not giving me the option to do so.
Component prepared. Starship critically damaged, vital ingredients missing. Unable to synthesize required components. Pulse engine requires a hermetic seal. Request assistance. Recommendation. Interaction. Comparison reveals a hermetic seal nearby. Salvage planetary chart from your distress beacon. Inside the beacon's housing, as well as its distress broadcast unit, it contains a planetary chart. Let's take the chart and let's view it. Navigational data received.
Our multi-tool has a scanner, a mining beam which is nearly finished. Let us add
technology installed.
Analysis carbon nanotubes. Already in our system that we can just
technology installed
apply. Do we have
have enough for a nanotube. Nanotube requires carbon, which we used all up to. And the machine whirs to life, spitting out supplies. I have the hermetic seal I need to repair my ship. Whoever it was that led me here, whoever left this message, perhaps they found themselves in the same situation as I do now. Okay, so we have the seal with us, but the weather is bad out there.
Storm clearing.
Okay, just to see, I did have bit of oh my, that's strange, it's on 98%. I thought it was like crested and low.
Technology recharge.
Okay, let's just check out this.
Radiation protection falling.
Nothing here.
that I can get some more ferrite now.
Radiation protection falling.
I mean, yeah, I'd have to actually make a nanotube. What, can I make one? Was it only one or was it two? One. Great. This one here needs three nanotubes. I need to make another three. So let's just I'd like to try and get a bit of a jump start on the game so that it doesn't take us that long to get into the actual game aspects. Just got. Damn. I know there was a way to split it. I just can't remember how. No, man, I don't want to use all of it. Split to C.
Technology recharge.
Let's just see how many of these nanotubes I need. Three. Okay, I managed to make three. Which helps with part of my. You'll identify different minerals, and that's because that's what it's all about, is scanning for different ingredients that can be used in constructing your base generally to survive.
Received.
generally just standing still and just scanning around me. Done the basics, analyze objects for rewards, that is exactly what I was doing. And head back to your starship. Okay. Okay, let's head back. Since we don't want to stick around in an atmosphere that is. Scanning this funny looking creature? Yeah, but it really looks kind of strange. Let's just scan for some more sodium because radiation is almost free, protection, I think.
Radiation protection. Component repaired. Technology repaired.
Right, we need to make pure ferrite for our thrusters, our launch thrusters. We do have some dihydrogen jelly apparently. So let's install that. Option. A blonde moment. I've done this game before and I've never had this problem. The only thing he's giving me is an oxygen recycler.
Technology installed.
Which is not what we're wanting.
Radiation protection falling.
Yeah, I can hear you. Why is this?
Zed. I just went totally black. Totally black. Allowing me to pick it up. No. Pick it up. It's not allowing me to pick it up. Thank you. At least our ship isn't on fire anymore. That is a plus. All systems functional. Seek answers amongst the stars. Press W to take. Let's get out of this radiated atmosphere. Transmission source 4925B. Please identify yourself. I'm so we shall identify ourselves. You are not alone. Follow the broadcast ends as strangely as it began. The final piece of the signal appears to be a set of planetary coordinates. Input the coordinate.
Dot. Alert. Navigational data received.
So we shall just turn around and see where we can see where the signal is coming from. It's coming from there. So let us go to the signal. Surface.
pulse scanner. And it says it's in this direction.
Radiation protection falling.
And why is it back on our same radiated planet? It's beyond me. Is this just running ahead? Sparking wires of the machine generates a signal, tapping out its broadcast into the void. Whoever left the message is long gone. Decipher the signal. Decoding. 16, 16, 16. Entry 4925C. No fuel in. Failed to reach station. Hazard protection low. No choice but to underground. Deploying base. Deployed base computer. As well as the log entry, the signal contains plans for a base computer and a terrain manipulator. With any luck, the base computer will hold more information about whoever is leaving their messages. Extract the plans. Wants me to build a base computer. I do not want to build it on a planet that is full of radiation. Survive on a radioactive planet? Hell no. Where's my ship? Turn around. Oh, so sorry, dude.
which on his left of this unit is unmistakable. They are an envoy of the Merchants Guild. They do not seem particularly interested in trading with me, however. Galactic Trade Terminal. Restricted area. Purchase components or purchase blueprints. I don't have any money. Paradise Planet. Now that is where I should have landed on. Let's go to the Paradise Planet.
surely all be water. Sending out a scan to so that hopefully I can pick up some form of life or building. Terrain manipulator. Okay, terrain manipulator.
carbon nanotube. Two carbon nanotubes. And we need carbon. Harvest some carbon to make some nanotubes, which will then allow us to make our manipulator. Metal, which is our right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to end it here so that I can do some harvesting offline, and so we're going to settle here on this paradise planet because it's much better than a radiation planet, and yeah, so we'll take it from here in the next one. Thank you very much for watching, and have a great day, evening, morning, wherever you are. See you in the next one.